Rampura, a remote district inhabited by a tribal population, is marked by extreme backwardness and abject poverty. Agriculture is the mainstay of the local population, though it is primarily subsistence due to very small land holdings. There is insignificant industrial or mining activity. Even the targeted welfare programs have inadequately benefited the tribal population. In this restrictive scenario, the youth had begun to migrate to other states to supplement the family income. Plight of minor girls is that their parents are persuaded by labor contractors to send them to work in the BT cotton farms of the nearby states. The soft finger of the minor girls are well suited for plucking the cotton. The inadequate living and working conditions in these farms have caused serious health issues for the minor girls. NGO in the districts of domicile and cotton farms appear to be compromised and have not effectively espoused the twin issues of child labor and development of the area. This was the description of the event, sir. The first question is, you are appointed as the district collector of Rampura. Identify the ethical issues involved.
There are multiple ethical issues and I would prioritize them as one, that the welfare grants do not reach the recipients and there is abject corruption and poverty in the area. And both are closely intertwined. The corruption part has to be addressed and the welfare measures that are taken ensure that every rupee designated for welfare must reach the actual recipient and there should be no corrupt practices. The development will have to be enforced and also the girl child who is instead of being in schools is sent to neighboring areas to pick up cotton, which is a human tragedy and must be addressed immediately. Then action must be taken against those who I would suspect that if there is an age barrier, then it would fall under the category of human trafficking. And also there are any number of government schemes that promote education for the girl child, which would include not only waiving of the tuition fees, but providing the uniforms, the stationery, the school books, and also the midday meals. The police will have to be sensitized because I see a clear nexus between the wheeler dealers, the corrupt elements, the human traffickers, and the local administration. That has to be set right. And the last but not the least, I would say that the public interface is sadly missing. I would say that NGOs with a track record of honesty, a track record of delivering, a track record of unimpeachable integrity, they must be roped in to chip in because it is not possible for the district magistrate to be in every nook and corner of the district. But yes, vibrant NGOs, especially with a due emphasis on women power, women shakti, they should be given the brief to address the issue and the allotment of funds, the utilization of funds, actual verification of the coming up of schools, PHCs, building of roads, connectivity towers, and also the welfare of the girl students should be the prime concern.
So, which specific steps will you initiate to ameliorate the conditions of minor girls of your district and to improve the overall economic scenario in the district?
Have a team of inspecting officers. Within my team, I would identify 50 officers, irrespective of rank, with at least 50% of them being women, to ensure that the ground reality is reported, addressed hands-on and in real time. Adequate funds be allotted to them, and also technology be used, whether it is the simple use of WhatsApp or the use of mobile telephony or also the SMS, so that any case of extortion, exploitation, leakage of funds is reported to the district headquarters. Also, the NGOs and also those who can be appointed special police officers under the provisions of the Police Act, they can also be given basic powers to do the reporting to the superintendent of police and to the district magistrate, the thanas and the tehsils galvanized into action. And any corrupt practices should be brought to notice and exemplary punishment be given to the corrupt elements, because at the back of every such miscarriage of justice, there is corruption, and corruption will have to be fought tooth and nail.
To have more such discussions and analysis, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for notifications on our upcoming videos.